Guten Tag, Kinder! Welcome to the Composer Detective, where we investigate the lives and the music of some of the world's great and influential composers. I am your host, George Frideric Handel. You may remember that I am a German composer from the Baroque era, though I lived most of my life in England. I am known for water music, operas, and oratorios such as Messiah. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! I am Handel, George Frideric Handel. Remember, the Baroque era of music was such a great time of grand, fancy, and almost decorated sounding music with a frivolous use of frills, trills, and extra notes. Johann Sebastian Bach and I were composers during this time. After us came the era called the Classical Era, where music was structured and orderly, like the music of Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Ludwig van Beethoven is also a classical composer, though his later music pushed orchestral music into a new Romantic era. The Romantic era was a period of music, art, and literature that is often characterized by an unabashed expression of emotion. Today, let me introduce you to a talented composer from the Romantic era. He is one of the three B's. Three composers who were born in Germany whose last names start with B. Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms. My last name does not start with B, though I was born in Germany, or they probably would have included me. Anyway, let me introduce Johannes Brahms.
Guten Morgen, Kinder. I am Johannes Brahms. I was just thinking about my childhood in Hamburg, Germany. My father was a musician who played many instruments, and I wanted him to teach me the one instrument he didn't know how to play very well, the piano. So he gave me my first lessons. He had to find me a teacher. Otto Kassel, who complained that though I was a good piano player, I would not stop my never-ending composing. Perhaps you're glad I didn't. My second teacher, Edward Merksen, encouraged me to study the works of Joseph Haydn, George Frideric Handel, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, and Johann Sebastian Bach.
I, Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, am the greatest composer who ever lived.
Yeah, Mozart, I did admire your work, and even collected yours and Haydn's autographs and first editions of your works. I, Johann Sebastian Bach, was also born in Germany, and I too come from a large family of musicians. In fact, the name Bach is synonymous with being a musician. My father taught me to play the violin, and my brother Christoph taught me to play the harpsichord and organ. I became very well known for playing the organ, and I was a prolific composer, writing my pieces to the glory of God.
Yeah, you inspired me to use lots of counterpoint in my compositions. And we have similar backgrounds in a way, Johann. As a youth, I had to help earn money for my poor family, so I got a job playing the piano in taverns.
What an awful job! I read adventure stories while I played to distract me from the rowdy atmosphere. Fortunately, I became friends with the Hungarian violinist, Edward Remeni, and we toured together, so I did not have to work in taverns forever. And I learned all about Hungarian music, which is why I composed a number of Hungarian dances, where you can hear my skill with rhythm. I, Antonin Dvorak, also love to use the melodies of my homeland, Bohemia, in my music. I am a famous patriotic Bohemian or Czech composer of the Romantic era, like you. And I'm well known for my New World Symphony. Thank you for your help and encouragement in my career. How could I not help and encourage such talent? I was poor once too, and Robert and Clara Schumann helped me reach a place where I could support myself composing. You see, one day I visited the home of Robert and Clara Schumann, famous composers and performers, who asked me to play some of my compositions for them. They were so impressed, so Robert wrote an article about how everyone should keep their eye on Johannes Brahms, because he was sure to be a distinguished composer, one of the most talented ever. I was so surprised by Robert's article, and almost mad. How nice to be complimented by one who was already such an illustrious composer. But then, I was afraid I would disappoint people with such expectations. So I worked hard to live up to my new reputation. I am very critical of my works, so over time, I have destroyed twice as many pieces as I have published. Duh. You and I share that critical concern for our works. I have such high standards for my works that I have burned some of them that were not good enough. Though I was poor, I was never cold. And of course, you were always living in the shadow of me, Ludwig von Beethoven.
Oh, it's Beethoven again.
Yeah, I was always being compared to you, Beethoven.
That's why I didn't compose a symphony until after I turned 42. People called my first symphony Beethoven's 10th Symphony. Then, because I love nature and walking in the woods like you did, I got my inspiration for my second symphony from my long walks in the forest. People compared my second symphony to your 6th Symphony, like a pastoral.
I see that, like me, you have never married, either.
Yeah, I also never married. My music kept me so busy.
And you left Germany to reside in Vienna, Austria. Are you going deaf, too? Well, you will never be Beethoven. There are and will be 1,000 princes. There is only one Beethoven. La 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 la.
Is he gone? I hate feeling like Beethoven is always looking over my shoulder.
It's okay. You have your own look with your famous beard, and you have become the remarkable composer that Robert Schumann thought you would. You are now one of the 3 B's of famous German composers. Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms. I love your variations on a theme by Haydn. And who doesn't know your sweet lullaby?
Lullaby and good night, with roses bedight, with lilies o'erspread, his baby's wee bed. Lay thee down and rest, may thy slumber be blessed. Lay thee down now and rest, may thy slumber be blessed.
So, let's review about me. Say my name after me, Johannes Brahms.
Johannes Brahms.
1833 to 1897.
1833 to 1897.
German Romantic Era composer.
German Romantic Era composer.
One of the 3 B's.
One of the 3 B's.
Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms.
Bach, Beethoven, and Brahms.
Known for use of counterpoint and rhythm. Orchestral pieces including four symphonies. Piano and chamber pieces.
Tonka, thank you for joining me on The Composer Detective today. Please join me again another time when we talk about other great composers like Johannes Brahms and me, Handel. Ephesians 5 says, "Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always giving thanks to God the Father for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ." Perhaps you like to sing or write music. Do it for the glory of God. Perhaps you will be the next great composer. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel and email list. Auf Wiedersehen from George Frideric Handel and The Composer Detective.